What's going on YouTube? This is Sean. I am back again. And in this video, we are going to be working on the arms and the legs of my Batman Beyond version 2.0. Here's a sneak peek of what I'm working on today. But first, let's start off with the neck guard. I've already got my patterns cut out in 2mm craft foam. And the reason why I went with 2mm is it's a little more flexible. And when you have something that wraps around your neck, then you don't want it like too stiff. You know what I mean? I'm going to start off by heat forming and rounding off the edges where the pieces are going to join each other. That's because I didn't make any inward angle cuts or anything like that. Everything was a straight cut. And the reason why I did this is because when I joined these two pieces together, I wanted to smoothly go together without anything beveling. And when I put these two patterns side by side, it looked like it didn't go together. But when I glued everything accordingly to the hash mark, it took its form just the way I wanted it to. Now I went ahead and did the same thing over on the other side of the neck guard. And you're gonna wanna make sure that these two pieces mirror each other, because once you get this part done, you're gonna do the center line together. And so far it is looking pretty legit. I didn't put anything in the center right there because I plan on putting some Velcro to the bottom of the neck guard, and it's going to attach to the undergarment. Let's move along to the gauntlets. Now I'm going to start off with the accents, and I've already got my patterns cut out. I rounded off the edges with some sandpaper so I can get it kind of looking smooth, and then I went and cut the patterns into smaller pieces because I'm going to take these two patterns and then stagger them by gluing them on top of each other. And since I'm gluing the smaller piece underneath the larger piece, I'm gonna have to trim down the tip just a little bit because I'm going to be gluing it in about a quarter of an inch in. And this is the underside of the top piece, or the center piece, I guess you could say. Now that my contact cement is dry to attack, I'm gonna go ahead and put the larger piece on top of the smaller piece, just like that, and do the same on the other side, which is going to mirror each other. And notice how the tip kind of lines up. And then I'm going to start off with the bottom and then work my way to the top and carefully make sure all my corners are nice and matched with each other, and you should have something that looks like this when you're done. This is the forearm cover or gauntlet piece. Call it whatever you want, but it looks kind of funky right now, but once you get it all glued together, it should look something that kind of looks like a turtle shell or something like that. It doesn't look like much now, but once I apply some heat and get some curvature on there, it's going to kind of take its form. But before I glue on these accents, I need to put some elastic in here. So I'm gonna take my X-Acto knife and I'm going to cut some slots there so I can slip some 1-inch elastic in there, and I'm going to glue it from underneath just like that. This gives it a much cleaner look. That way your hot glue is not exposed on the outside. And once you have it all glued together, it should look something like that. And it becomes really comfortable to put these things on because once you flex, it flexes with you. I went and applied some heat to the accents and rounded it off just a little bit. That way it can form around the forearm cover, and I'm going to put it on just like that. Before I glue everything on, I want to make sure everything is nice and centered. And once I have it nice and centered, I'm going to take a pen and mark out where I need to apply my glue. And people are always asking me, what kind of glue are you using, Sean? Well, I prefer to use Barge contact cement. Dab Wellwood is a cheaper alternative, but by far Barge contact cement is my favorite. I even went and applied some Barge around the elastic because I'm going to glue some accents on top of that, which will give it a much cleaner look. Now that my glue is dried to attack, I'm going to make sure that my accents are nice and straight and on there, because once you get it on there, man, it's gonna be very difficult to get it back off. I cut these little pieces out of 5mm craft foam, and these little accent pieces are going to reinforce the foam and prevent it from splitting on me when I put it on, and it also looks cool too. What do y'all think? I went in and drew in some marks so I can glue on my bat fins. I cut the base of the fins in a 45 degree angle, that way when I glue it on, it would lean towards the back. And you're probably wondering why I went with three fins instead of two, because Batman Beyond has two. Well, their Batman Beyond only has two. Mine has three. And that's only because I couldn't fit four on there, because mine's special. Let's move along to the bicep guards. I've already got all my patterns cut out in some 6mm EVA foam. Got my barge contact cement already put on there. It's dry to attack, and I am assembling all my pieces. I'm gonna start off by doing all the pie cuts, I guess that's what you call it, and then join it down the center, just like that. Now I did cut both edge of the center piece in an inward angle cut, that way when I glue the side pieces on there, it'll give me a slight bevel. And it will look something like that. And now it's time to join it from the back, which I'm going to carefully align my piece and make sure everything is nice, flush, and flat. And now I'm going to glue this lower back piece, starting off at the center and then working my way to the corners and down to the edge, just like that. So far so groovy, and my bicep guard is just about done. Now the problem with this bicep guard is that it will slip onto a human's arm no problem, but my mannequin, well, he doesn't move, so I have to cut this line right down the middle and then put some elastic there, that way I can actually slip it onto display. And for those of y'all that have larger arms, then this would probably be a good idea to do too. So I went ahead and cut it down the middle, cut some slots in there, and then I'm going to insert a 1-inch elastic on there. Then I'm going to hot glue it from underneath. And for those of y'all that have smaller arms like I do, then you can just skip this process and glue some Velcro on the inside, which will attach to the under armor. Moving along to the shoulders. Now these pieces do look kind of funky, but once you glue them all together, they'll look really cool, trust me. Now, I did cut the shoulder pieces in 8mm EVA foam because I wanted the thickness, and I did cut one of these pieces in an inward angle cut, that way it'll give me that bevelness. As for this center piece, I did cut that in some 5mm craft foam, that way I can have that staggering look, which kind of gave it a pretty cool effect. And now I'm gonna add this low-rise shoulder guard thingy. I just made that up. Seems legit, right? But it made my shoulder pad look really cool. It kind of gave the shoulder pad an edgy flair, which I think complements the rest of the armor. Now I'm gonna apply some heat and put some curvature around it, kind of make the foam take its shape a little bit better, and now it's looking way sweeter. Now I'm going to take this shoulder pad and glue it onto the bicep guard. Now the placement of the shoulder pad on the bicep guard really depends on the length of your arm. So glue it wherever it fits, I guess. Moving along to the legs, I'm going to start off by working on the thigh guards. Now I did cut these J-shaped looking things in an inward angle cut. That way when I glue it to the center, it'll bevel just a little bit and help take shape around the thighs. Now notice that I use different thickness for the center and the rest of the thigh guards because I wanted to stand out just a little bit. The centerpiece was actually 8mm EVA foam and the rest of it is 6mm EVA foam. And so far it's starting to look pretty legit. Now I'm going to glue this back piece to the back of the thigh guard, which is supposed to glue completely around just like that. Just slip it on and it'll be held up by these hip covers, which I'm using some polyester outdoor sports fabric that I like using for most of my cosplay build. And I know a lot of you guys are wondering, where do I find this material? Because I use it on all my cosplay builds. Well, I did list this material in my Amazon shop, and you can buy it by the yards. I'll leave links in the description down below. I like this material because it's just as strong as faux leather, but it's got like a fabric texture that I can glue onto foam or glue foam onto it. I'm gonna use my wood burner and cut some slots so I can hot glue some elastic on here, but if this slip around your legs without having to put elastic on, then go for it. The reason why I'm doing this is because this place thigh is a little bit thicker than the thigh guard, so I have to actually put some elastic here so it'll fit on him. And now we're down to the shin guard. I've already got all my pieces cut out in some 6mm EVA foam. I wish I had used 8mm because that would have looked a whole lot better, but because I ran out of 8mm, I had to settle for using 6mm, which turned out pretty good. Now I did cut all the connecting edges in an inward angle cut, that way when I glued everything together, it formed really nicely around the leg. I started off by attaching the two side pieces together, and then once I was done with that, I went and attached it to the center piece. Now the shin guard for the left leg and the right leg are actually identical, so I actually just repeated this process for the other leg. And you're probably thinking, well, Sean, I don't have identical legs like you do. Well, I don't either, but the beauty of building your cosplay out of EVA foam is that once you have it all strapped on, then the foam kind of forms to the leg, so yeah. So far so groovy, right? I mean, the shin guard looks pretty cool. Like, I almost don't have to do anything else to it, but I'm gonna add some knee pads to it so it'll look cooler. And I mean, knees need some protection too, right? Now that I got my knee pad all glued together, I decided I'm going to just glue this onto the rest of the shin guard. And I'm going to draw me a little line, which is going to be about a quarter inch in. And I'm going to apply some contact cement, which I will then glue under the top of the shin guard. I'm going to carefully align the edge of the center of the shin guard to that line that I drew onto the knee pad. That way, it'll look way cooler. And what do y'all think? I think it needs more accents. But before I do that, I want to make sure everything can strap down into place. I took my wood burner and burned in some slots here so I can stick some Velcro, which I'm going to hot glue underneath and use my high-tech clamps to hold it in place until the glue hardens back up. Now, I like to use high-temp hot glue to make sure everything is glued down nice and on there. Now I am going to put some additional accents onto the shin guard. I've already cut my pieces out. The inner connecting edges are cut in an inward angle. That way it'll bevel and wrap nicely around the shin guard. I took a pen, I scored where I needed to apply my contact cement, and once all that was dried, I carefully aligned it and put it on there. And so far, it's looking way cooler. Then I'm gonna finish it off by applying some heat so I can close this foam up and get it ready to seal and paint. Here's a sneak peek of everything that was already painted and weathered. There's a few things that I want to add on to it, like the shoe guard and the accents for the hip cover, but I'll cover that in more detail in the next video. I just wanted to show you guys where I'm at so far. Now, if you're into this kind of stuff, I mean, if you're really into it, the templates will be available in my Etsy shop. I will have the files separated to where if you only want the body or if you only want the arms and the legs, then they'll be available separately. Or if you want the whole kit, that'll be there too. I mean, if that's what you're into. And if you're new to cosplay and you've been pondering the idea for a long time, well, just jump right into it and get your hands dirty. And if you're looking for tools and supplies, then swing by my Amazon shop where I list a bunch of stuff that I use. You can get your barge contact cement there. You can also get foam, floor mat, and even the cooler EVA foam. That's in there too. I mean, if that's what you're into. Well, I guess that's it for this video. Make sure you guys hit that like button if you got something out of this video. And if you're new to this channel, make sure you hit that subscribe button because I'm always coming up with really cool ideas and stuff. Make sure you guys follow me on my social network, my Facebook, my Instagram, and whatever. I guess I'll see you guys in the next video.